Hi guys, welcome back to my project. I'm Eric here. Today I'm trying to take a look at this product together. It's TTGO camera plus model here. Let's see what's different from the ES32CAM AI Thinker we have used so far. Let's get started. I bought two products. One is product with a camera in the front and a camera in the back. The product with the camera in the back is with fisheye lens. There is a video comparing the OV2640 lens in my video. Please check it out if necessary. The reason why I bought this is because of my future projects. Anyway, here is our old friend ES32 Cam. Compared to this, there are many differences. IPS 1.3-inch display is noticeable first. It will be very convenient because we can see the incoming video right away or display other data. Also, it includes an I2S MEMS microphone that was not on the ES32 Cam. If we make them deliver not only images but also voice data, I think we can implement video calls such as FaceTime. Very interesting. The camera sensor is the same OV2640, so the maximum resolution is UXVJ, which is 1600 pixel by 1200 pixel. It had been better if there was a higher version of the sensor, but it's not. USB to TTL programmer is included, so FTDI programmer is no longer required for debugging. I personally like this part. It's annoying when I need to put something. Unfortunately, there was no buttons available. This button is for reset and cannot be used. That's too bad. I think I need a button to trigger something. Let's see how we can handle it without the function button. Finally, there is something that needs to be mentioned most importantly. It's the size of the external SPI RAM. The size of the PS RAM is 8 MB. This will enable us to do more diverse projects with this. Even though it's restricted to use, it's going to be very useful. Also, I need to drill down about how to use it freely. Hopefully, there is a chance to show you guys soon. Okay then, let me power on it. There is a built-in program, so I just tried it. First, it checks if there is an SD card. After a while, the screen will tell you which word you must say. I think this is to make sure that the built-in microphone is working properly. If you look at the source code, it already has a model for particular words and tasks that compare voice data from the microphone to check the similarity with the pre-selected words seem to be working. After recognizing words, I can see the images through the display. It's similar to the project we have been working on except for voice recognition. It's not very fast, but it's working without a problem. The final test is the camera web server. It's the first program you will encounter after purchasing an ES32 Cam, and you can test many things. This camera web server I'm using is a version modified to show the current FPS on the built-in screen. The source code can be found in the description below. One interesting about using the TTGO Camera Plus model is that I have not encountered any errors from the camera. Sometimes ES32 Cam says the brownout detector was triggered or something like that. If you have lots of stress from that kind of issue, I recommend you to try this one. It'll be great if there were no bottlenecks. It's operating the same as the ES32 Cam. It's starting with the VGA and going up to UXGA resolution, which is the maximum. You can check the image size, average FPS on the right. There seem to be many projects that can be done with this. I'll try to make interesting projects. Okay, it's all for today's video. Thank you guys, see you in the next project.